On the 14th of October 1944, inside of an SS car that had been sent for him from Hitler, next to a German general, Erwin Rommel died. His hand had been forced, and he was given three options, all of which would have resulted in his death. The other two options he was given would have resulted in his brutal execution, either on the guillotine, or on the gallows inside of a German prison. The skilled German general had been linked to the July 20th plot, a treasonous plan to assassinate Adolf Hitler and then bring down the Nazi government. In the wake of the bomb going off in Hitler's Wolf's Lair, thousands of members of the military and also civilians were arrested. They were then sentenced to death and executed in horrific ways. But Rommel was too powerful, and he was seen as too much of a hero in the eyes of the German people. But Hitler had to be clever with how he dealt with the demise and downfall of the Desert Fox. However, his funeral was a huge spectacle, and Rommel was given a state funeral, but it was not what he wanted, and Rommel specifically stipulated that he did not want a Nazi funeral. But this was not adhered to, and his coffin was draped in Nazi insignia. Join us today to look at Erwin Rommel's Nazi funeral, and as always, please support our channel by subscribing. Erwin Rommel was a hugely decorated soldier of the First World War, and following the end of the conflict, he wrote many books on military tactics and Hitler read these. He would become Hitler's favourite general, and he would be promoted above more experienced military officers. But he begged to take control of a panzer division during the Second World War, and Rommel was given command of the 7th Panzer Division during the invasion of France in 1940. He became a skilled commander, and was great at offensive tactics and warfare, and with these successes he was then placed in control of the German war effort in North Africa, and he was in command of the German and Italian soldiers. He was defeated, following a number of victories for the British, at El Alamein, and Rommel was then sent back to Germany. Hitler then gave him another huge job. This time he was involved in commanding defensive German forces in Normandy, and Hitler was anticipating a huge Allied invasion that would come in the form of D-Day. The Nazis knew that the Allies would try to get a foothold in France, and they would do this, but Rommel was not a defensive commander. He was better on the offensive, but now he spent time looking at bunkers and fortifications that were being made, rather than attacking the enemy on the front foot. However, as the Second World War effort stalled for the Germans, following Stalingrad and the Normandy landings, Erwin Rommel began to question Hitler's position in the German military, and he did speak with other commanders about this. He even sent a letter to Hitler about this, and following the July 20th plot, he would be implicated in the bombing of Hitler's Wolf's Lair. The plan was to assassinate Hitler, and the dictator was injured in the attack, but the subsequent military coup failed and fell flat. As mentioned, thousands would be executed in reprisal for the plot, and Rommel was then targeted. Martin Bormann, Hitler's private secretary, stated in a letter to Hitler that the late General Stulpnagel, Colonel Hofnacker, Kluger's nephew, who had been executed, Lieutenant Colonel Rafjens, and several living defendants have testified that Field Marshal Rommel was perfectly in the picture about the assassination plan and has promised to be at the disposal of the new government. But then Gestapo agents were sent to Rommel's house in Ulm to keep an eye on him. But the question was now there for Hitler as to what to do with Rommel. Hitler's main problem was that Rommel was a hero to the German people, following his actions on the battlefield, and in the eyes of the German people he was as popular as Hitler, certainly more so from a military perspective. Hitler then told his generals to convene a court-martial, and Field Marshal Keitel, Field Marshal von Rundstedt, Heinz Guderian, and others gathered and discussed information about Rommel's involvement. The normal protocol would have seen the Desert Fox being taken into the People's Court, and he would probably have been executed in a terrible way following this, regardless of his innocence or not. The court-martial assumed that Rommel was part of the plot, but Hitler knew that having Rommel on trial for treason would demoralise the German people and would damage the war effort. Because of this, he issued Rommel three choices. The first was to defend himself in front of Hitler personally in Berlin, but one of the inner circle could have shot and executed him inside Hitler's own private quarters. The second choice was that he had to go up in front of the People's Court, which was not favourable. But the third choice was that he would take his own life quietly, and that his death in his reputation would be protected, and he would die a war hero. But Generals Baldorf and Meisel were sent to Rommel's home on the 14th of October 1944, and they informed him of the choices Hitler had given him. Rommel chose to take his own life quietly, and he made sure that his wife following his death would get his full pension, and that he would die a hero. Bergdorf had with him a cyanide capsule ready, and Rommel chose this, and he would then tell his wife and son about his death. He got into a car driven by an SS member, and he was then taken out of the village and into a forest. Meisel and the driver got out of the car, leaving Rommel and Bergdorf together. Rommel then took the cyanide, and minutes later he died in the back of the car, his Field Marshal's baton having fallen onto the floor. 10 minutes later, Rommel's wife was told of her husband's death. Rommel was then taken to the Wagner Schule Field Hospital, and the people were then told he died of a heart attack or a cerebral embolism, which was caused from complications from skull fractures he suffered when his staff car was strafed months before. Hitler then ordered a national day of mourning for Erwin Rommel, despite knowing the truth about his death. He was made a hero, and following his death, a number of death masks were captured of his face, so he could be venerated for centuries to come. But plans were then made by the Nazis for the state funeral of Erwin Rommel, a man who was killed in a sense by the Nazis. This would not take place in Berlin, as was expected, but in Ulm, as Rommel requested, near to where he died and where he lived with his family. Rommel had also stated that he did not want his funeral to be a huge Nazi occasion, and he did not want any Nazi insignia displayed, only military signs. But this was of course not adhered to, and Hitler would see the funeral of Rommel as an opportunity to unite Germans in grief for a celebrated general, and he believed it may have unified Germany and got them to get behind the war effort, with the people wanting to avenge Rommel. They had been of course told that the Allies were responsible for his death. On the 18th of October 1944, the state funeral of Rommel took place, 4 days after his death. His coffin was taken into the town hall of Ulm, and was carried on a gun carriage, but on top of the coffin was draped a huge Nazi flag with a swastika on it. The coffin was taken into the town hall by 8 Germans in their full uniform, and the funeral service then took place. Attending were many senior Nazis. Hitler would not, and he would send a representative, and on display were Rommel's medals. Speeches were made and took place, and stood by the coffin were German soldiers armed with ceremonial swords. Gerd von Rundstedt spoke to the mourners who were there, and he spoke of Rommel's successes in the German army. He said, on the battlefield of Normandy, General Field Marshal Rommel suffered severe injury in a car crash. A cruel fate took the general away from his place just as the fight was about to reach its peak. He was injured on the battlefield amongst his soldiers. A tragedy took him forever away from us. One of the great soldierly leaders, which is seldomly gifted to a people, has left us with Field Marshal Rommel. The tireless warrior was filled with a National Socialist spirit, which was a source of power and foundation for his actions. My dear Rommel, our Führer and Supreme Commander sends you, through me, his deepest gratitude and sincere farewell. Flowers were then placed on the coffin, then the coffin following the ceremony left the town hall. There were thousands of people who had lined the streets of Ulm, and many looked on as Rommel's coffin was carried by soldiers down the stairs of the town hall, and it was then placed on the back of the gun carriage. Hundreds of soldiers stood and paid their respects to Rommel, and also kept the population in check, and Nazi symbols and swastikas were everywhere, flying from windows lining the streets and from the town hall to where he would be buried. The parade was huge, and the coffin was pulled behind a German truck, and many German soldiers sat on top as it went past people. And as it went past people, Rommel's coffin was saluted with the Nazi raised arm salute. Despite not wanting a Nazi send-off, this was exactly what Rommel got. He was then buried in Herlingen, a short distance west from Ulm. But Erwin Rommel's funeral was not what he wanted, and it was almost a sham due to the fact he was slaughtered in a sense by Hitler and the Nazi party. He was given choices by the dictator that would only have resulted in his death. And because of this, Rommel would die inside of an SS car with the cyanide capsule he consumed. His funeral was a huge Nazi occasion, and the people of Ulm flocked to see off Rommel, and it was shown all over Germany in huge propaganda efforts by Goebbels. But the funeral of Rommel was a shocking Nazi one, and despite it showing him as a hero to the people of Germany, it's not what he wanted. Thanks for watching. To support our channel, please make sure to subscribe. And once again, thank you so much for watching.